Hello friends, my name is Miss Amber and this is my friend Miss Abby.
Hi.
This is part two, so make sure that you check out part one before you watch this one. We have been learning that God hears our prayers and that we can trust that God will answer them too. The Bible says that there was a man named Zechariah who was God's special friend. He was a very old man and his wife Elizabeth was a very old woman. When you're very, very old, your body doesn't work as well as it did when you were younger. Zechariah and Elizabeth had always wanted a baby. They prayed and asked God for a baby, but they didn't have one when they were younger. And now that they were old, they thought it was too late for them to have a baby. One day, Zechariah was in God's special house. Zechariah loved to spend time with God in his special place. The Bible says that in God's special house, Zechariah burned incense, which is something that smells sweet, kind of like a candle. Usually, Zechariah burned incense when he and God's other friends were praying. While the people were outside praying, Zechariah was still inside God's special house, when out of nowhere, an angel appeared to him. Zechariah was surprised and afraid, but the angel said, "Do not be afraid. God heard your prayer. God hears your prayers too. Have you asked God for something? I know I have. God hears when you talk to him. He might not answer right away, but you can trust that he will answer you in his time." The Bible says God heard Zechariah's prayers. The angel told Zechariah that his wife Elizabeth was going to have a baby. The angel said Zechariah should name the baby John and that John was going to have a special job, helping people meet Jesus. But Zechariah had a hard time believing that his wife Elizabeth could have a baby because they were so old. Zechariah said to the angel, "How is this possible?" And the angel told Zechariah that God would be able to do it. And then he made it to where Zechariah couldn't talk. Could you imagine? Zechariah wasn't able to say anything until his baby was born. The neighbors of Zechariah and Elizabeth said that the baby should be named after Zechariah, but Elizabeth said, "No, his name is John." Zechariah agreed, and since he couldn't talk, he wrote down the name John, and after he wrote it, he could talk again. The neighbors were amazed that they could tell that John was going to have a special job from God. Thanks for joining us, and make sure that you're on the lookout for part three.